This is
process tends to be the thing with Gong. So rather than having like a bright idea about something very meaningful, we arrive at the thing that we think's meaningful via the process.
Yeah, we started from all these concepts that we'd written down and ideas that we'd written, and I think Darcy would pull seeds from that, and those seeds would feed into physical tasks. And then those tasks would result in more seeds, which we would then seed other things with, and it would kind of weave around, and we'd eventually pull things.
Kind of, it's more, it almost was more image-based, yeah, in this creation. So we would find one image or one skill that was really interesting and try and really zoom in on that thing and then expand it. So, like, for example, the births.
One of the big scenes in the show is vegan home birth, and that is, it takes the traditional birth action, the acrobatic trick where you slide over the shoulders and you pull them out the legs, and then we pretty much went, what else can we do with this trick? Can it fall off of two highs? Can it fall off of three highs? Where can it come out of? Can we do other tricks that end in births? Can the birth start and then go somewhere and wrap back around onto the three high? And so that really opened up our eyes to what new languages and physicality can come from taking a simple skill, I guess.
Because we agreed that the Simo beginning duet didn't feel like the beginning. I had a provocation for the first thing, which was you jumping on your shoulders.
Oh yeah.
That yeah, jump up, oh, yeah, is just such a dynamic start, and you can do
and really clear.
Do that. Yeah. What's that?
I said better not drop it.
Better not drop it. Yeah,
that's
yeah,
the classic. That's the like first shot in space. Space. Yeah. Like, yeah. Like, no.
The first trick.
Okay. Let's awesome. Do that. Where's that?
Super sick
texture. Texture one.
This is a Lewie and Lisa belly walk.
Yeah. Should we go? That's really cute. Renaming that skill. Is there anything we have fast that can go up?
Would that go in? Could we switch the order of that and Wizzy's? So it goes out of that. You come down, a man comes in, and it goes into Wizzy's, and you go around through everyone.
Because the pass into a man, yeah, at the moment's real awkward.
But it also feels pretty like I've just flown this whole thing, and then now I flow this whole thing. So I wouldn't mind splitting up Wizzy's and World Class anyway, just because it feels a little bit too...
Yeah,
so close, yeah, together. But maybe that's just me thinking that.
It could be sweet.
I'd be keen to try it.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
it's such a beautiful slow thing, and then everything else speeds yeah, up and you're still this close.
Oh yeah.
It's
yeah,
a nice
cool
way to get everyone yeah on stage.
Let's try that then.
Well, where are we? Just straight after that?
We're kind of just grouping things into what things could go
where's
together.
Cool.
Well, I like to think of it as like a... it's from four directions. The beginning is we engineer from concept, which I sort of just went over. So there's lots of ways that you can, you know, read theories on astrophysics or cells in the body or this or that and build tasking elements around that, like dance does a lot of. You can also just stare really hard at the things on the floor and engineer from the physical and discover, which is another really nice way. But then with someone like Geoff Cobham involved and someone like Ben Walsh in the early stages and Ekrem Phoenix now, being provoked from the musical end as well. So there's this sort of, for me and this company, it's such a collaborative kind of process from each one of those angles. So concept, physical design, visual design and sound design. And then hopefully you give enough room to all of those creatives to have enough buy-in that it's really rich territory for everyone.
And here it is. Jump, go! One more, everyone.
Yep.
down to the ground, and up on the
shoulders. Got it. There it is.
Oh my god. Well, basically improvised.
Good. Thanks. Next bit.
Kind of creating a new physical language or a unique physical language to Out of Chaos was actually kind of easier than we expected because the cast was quite a new group of people and they move in a very different way and they have a different skill set. And so from the get-go, it was easy to create in a way we haven't created before.
Yeah, and a lot of that skill stuff is driven by the individuals in the work. They'll get together and they'll go, wouldn't it be awesome if we could do this skill, or we want to train this and that. Mm. And we would be on the outside, you know, thinking about how where they fit and what they all mean and how they could sit within a work.
And I think because a lot of the original GOM crew weren't in the cast, that created a totally new style of movement as well. There's like far less swinging and more of a focus on kind of towers and different ways to move in and out of skills.
I really love the trajectory that GOM has taken. I really love that every time we have a meeting about what Out of Chaos is, we always go back to, okay, so does that build on what has happened before in the previous shows? Does it gel with, like, the whole kind of timeline of creation? Does it leap too far out of what Gravity and Other Myths is as a company, what they've put on stage before? And so I personally love those moments where you're like, that references that line from Simple Space, or that references this bit from Freefall, or that reference. Like, I love that if you come and you've seen all the shows and you know the company, you'll go, oh, that's familiar, but it's never just like, oh, they've done the same thing. I love that we always go, all right, we don't want to put the same tricks in the show. If there's a trick in this show that was in a previous show, it has to be integrated differently, do a different thing, say a different thing. All that stuff, even use of voice and everything is really interesting. And I think having Darcy direct this show, having Geoff come back on, having the original core members both in the ensemble and outside looking in, it constantly keeps us really focused.
Watch them guys once you come up. Look at them. That's gonna work. Not to use a cliche, but you do really want to challenge what has been before. You want to challenge the physical research. You want to, you know, you want to don't want to do tired things or copy. And you've got a bunch of people to please. But at the end of the day, I think nothing risked, nothing gained. You know, you've got actually got to risk more than anything. I think that's at the center of the Matrix, is the risk that it could fall in a heap and be nothing as well. Yeah. Otherwise, why bother? Thank you.
Sorry. Down it. Cut it.